Today I want to show you a book on free motion quilting that's great for beginners. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. Before we get into today's book review, if you're new to my channel, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. Today, I'm taking a look at Free Motion Quilting 101 by Ashley Nichols. Now, this is Techniques and Patterns for Beginners, and it's published by the Taunton Press. I have a lot of free motion quilting books, but more and more good ones keep coming out, and this is one of those books I just had to add to my library because of the way she goes through the different designs and the information that she presents in the book. And it's great for beginners, but if you have been free motion quilting for a while, I think you'll also find this book very interesting. She starts out by telling you how to get ready and how to free motion quilt, so that's always good. So again, if you're a beginner, this is crucial. If you already know how to do free motion quilting, well, you might learn something that you didn't know before. So she talks about getting ready, and that involves, of course, getting your sewing machine set up and the proper feet to use and everything. So she actually goes through different sewing machines as well and gives you an idea of what is a good thing about them and what the price point is on them and that. So that can be really helpful if you don't have a machine yet for quilting, if you're fairly new into it. Some of this information can be very helpful. And of course, setting up your space. So there's a lot of information besides just the machine itself, okay? But it's getting you all ready to set up in the best way possible. Of course, you've got to talk about thread when you're talking about free motion quilting, and she goes through different types of thread as well and information about it. And again, that cost, which is also very helpful, I find. And then of course, once you've gone through the setup and you're ready to free motion quilt, she wants to show you how to get started. And she also talks about ergonomics in here. So making sure you're properly set up with your body in relationship to, you know, sitting at your sewing machine. And that's really important because if you are not comfortable when you're free motion quilting, because it's something you can be sitting there and doing for quite some time, you're going to find that your shoulders are sore, your back is sore, things like that. So talking about ergonomics is always good when you're talking about any type of quilting, and she does give you a little bit of information on that. She also goes through and talks about some of the problems you can have, what your thread and your stitching is going to look like if you're moving your hands too fast or moving your hands too slow. So people will all often wonder, what's going on? Why are my stitches looking like this? Well, you'll find an explanation for that in Ashley's book. She also talks about stitch length. She talks about tension, and there's photos in the book to show you all those things. And that's really helpful too. You have to have photos to see, you know, issues and to see, you know, what it should like look like and what to do if it doesn't look like that. So if yours don't look like hers and they're looking like some of the, you know, it shouldn't look like this photos, you're going to go, that's me. And then you're going to see how to fix that. And then you're going to see what it should look like. And that really helps you to make sure that your stitching is going along the way you want it to. So the next area, part two, is patterns and projects. And she has her patterns divided into different sections. So she has nature-inspired patterns, geometric patterns, she has mixed media designs, and she has a sunset picnic blanket, which is going to combine some different designs in it. So when she starts off with the nature-inspired pattern, she has things like pebbles and leaves, things like that. This particular one she calls whale's tail, I believe is what she calls it, whale tails, okay? And this is what you'll see in all the different motifs she's going to show you, and this is one of the things I really like about this book. She shows you a trace and practice sheet. So you could, you know, make a copy of this so that you can do it yourself if you don't want to actually write in the book. But she shows you how to make that design in this area and also kind of in more detail if you were over here, more information on it. So for example, in this particular one, you can see the red arrows are showing you're going to go up, you're going to go down, you're going to go across, you're going to go up and down. So you know where to start and how to move through that design. She also has more explanation over here. So she's saying, like, as you go through, part of this design is straight, part of it's, you know, it's curved, part of it's straight. So she shows you a little more information over here and how you can actually use it on a quilt as well. So I like that idea of being able to trace, because even if you're drawing something with your hands and not actually stitching, you still get that motion and you build up that muscle memory. So when you sit down to actually stitch it, your hands already know what to do. So really great to have that in this book. She also has projects in the different areas. So for example, these are rustic placemats and she's using her leaf design here. And so she shows you how to make those. So a simple project, which is always good when you're first learning how to free motion quilt, that you're not doing a huge quilt to start off with. Start with something smaller so you can get some practice, but also get it done in a timely manner. Okay, here's another one of these designs. This is also lots of fun, traveling spirals, okay? Or I might call this a scribble. But you know, this breaks the rules where people will say you shouldn't cross your quilting lines, but you sure can. So again, she's showing you how to move through that design, and then you've got that trace and practice. So you can actually trace over, you know, her design that she's got on here, and then she's got lots of room for you to continue on and do your own drawing. Okay, so lots of different designs in this book. And then one of the things I found that really interesting in here, and I definitely want to try this, is in this mixed media designs area, because what she's doing here is she's painting on fabric first and then quilting around what she's painted to create a design. So she goes through the different types of paint she uses, different types of brushes and everything. And so there's a lot of detail here. She also talks about adding fusel web applique or raw edge applique to that painted fabric. So that's very interesting too. So you've got a lot of different things going on there, right? But if you like to do mixed media things, I think this would be so much fun. And then she has a project. So here she's painted, you know, got some different paints on here. She's got some fusible web applique in here, these little triangles or fusible web applique. And then she's got, I also call this scribble stitching, where she's just free motion quilted around there. So she's also free motion quilted some words in there too. So you can draw those on and then just stitch around them. So this is just a lot of fun, right? So you can have some fun with painting, with, you know, not having to paint any kind of a landscape or a portrait or anything, but just color on fabric and then have some fun stitching around it. So very free form and very freeing. I really like that a lot. And then you get to the sunset picnic blanket, which is at the end here. And this is where she's using different designs, different motifs on this particular project. So it's a simple project. You can see there's just five different fabric, different types of fabric colors and just in rectangular shapes. And then she's doing different types of designs on it. So she shows you how to make it and everything. This is a great way to practice. Okay, so you're practicing different designs in each of the areas. And by the time you've done this particular project, it's not huge, but it's bigger than the placemats. By the time you've done this project, you will have had a lot of practice at the particular motifs that you're putting in there. And of course, you could do this project again and choose different motifs to go in there as well. And at the end, she also shares information on blocking, binding, and finishing your quilt, because that's the next step right after you've finished it. So lots of information in here as well. So lots of photos in here to help you. I really like the idea of those practice sheets that she has for each of the motifs. I like how she shows you how to start and move through them, because sometimes people don't show the arrows and it's a little confusing sometimes. So I really like that. So if you're learning how to free motion quilt, or you want to add another really good book to your free motion quilting library, I recommend Free Motion Quilting 101 by Ashley Nichols. Thanks for watching today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your quilting friends. And if you want more helpful quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.